Hello fellow tankers, bonjour amis tankistes. In this video, I will present you a huge carry on the Maginot Line map. But before that, let me summarize my main tutorial that I posted recently to mention first that I really do prefer the arcade version of this map compared to the RB version of this map, which is too big in a sense, and also which favor spawn camping. This arcade battle is actually very very difficult, especially when you play from the south side. From the north side, my advice is that you first go to B, which will be easy to cap in the beginning, and then advance in this area, and ultimately actually push toward there. Obviously, some people can go directly to A. From the blue side, ideally, you should do the same. The problem is that if you go to B, you will be alone, because most of the time, the blue side just stop there, as you will see actually in this battle. So right now, I would say that I used to go to B in the beginning from the blue side, but now I really advise you to go to A, and ultimately, as you will see, you can also cross from A to B. So anyway, let's go for this hectic and extremely tense battle, and which I think will indeed illustrate the fact that this arcade version of this map is much more fun and interesting than the pretty dull RB version of the map that I also address in my main tutorial. So I am playing my 7.7 French lineup, starting with this MX30 1972. And we are in at least 8.3 battle, maybe 8.7. Well, let's check. Yes, 8.7, 8.7 battle, so full up tier. And as I just mentioned, right now, most of the time from this side, decide first to go toward A. As you will see, the enemy side will cap me, if I remember properly. Although my squad mate is entering B alone, but that's unfortunately what will happen very often from this south side. Most of the time, people don't push at all B. Which in principle is a mistake, but since you also play in a team, you have to adapt to what the usual teams are doing. Obviously, most of our team is fighting around C, which is essentially useless in this battle. So here I was a bit waiting for the my life to busy this PTL-02, nasty Chinese tank. So really on this map, again, go for the two connected cars, A and B, like in all maps, which are horizontal in the sense that three caps are at equal distance from the two spawn. Try to concentrate, especially if you play alone, on the two connected caps, which will allow you to to fight for two caps at the same time. So here I'm using my 20 mm gun to break the fences and kill this T-54. Now the M60 that I wrecked a bit in the beginning will probably push me. And unfortunately, my shot is not great, but his shot is even worse. So I'm killing his gunner and finish him, which allows me to keep A. So far, it's a kind of stalemate. But as predicted, the enemy team is very strong on B. And now I'm showing you this move, which I've already shown you in my main tutorial, if I am not mistaken. This crossing between A and B, obviously you have to be a bit careful with the campers in the north, but very often if you have a good timing, you can actually cross. It's actually easier to cross, as I have shown in my main tutorial, easier to cross when you are playing from the north side, which is maybe again another reason why this map is a bit unbalanced. Definitely the configuration against B, around B, sorry, is definitely favorable to the north side. So here I'm taking a bomber, let me accelerate. I think unfortunately my plane, no, my plane will not be shot. So I'm capping B, and I see that there is actually an enemy tank there, but fortunately bombing, he was probably not aware that I was in a bombing bomber, and he didn't rush me. So as you can see, we are only not even at half time, and so far so good. I mean, I have capped A, I have capped B. All right, now I'm taking this opportunity that this T-54 has been wrecked by an enemy to kill it. So obviously, around C, the two teams are extremely passive, which makes really this fight around C completely absurd. And honestly, you will not find the best players of the two teams fighting up there. So here you will see that I will be struggling awfully to kill this Centauro. For a few patches now, the light vehicles are extremely difficult to kill. And normally, you would expect a powerful hit shell or hit FS shell to one-shot this Centauro, but unfortunately I'm trying to get the driver. Yes, I got the driver, but he recruits some other crew, and ultimately, yes, I hit it, but that was a bit ridiculous. BMPs, Beglet Panzer are also extremely difficult to kill, even with APDS or APFS. Yes. So at this point, I have to tell you that I was extremely confident. Maybe why I'm a bit reckless now, and I did not really suspect that this game would be actually more difficult than it seems right now. So ultimately, I will die. See, I'm exposed, and let's move to my next tank. So I am respawning with the premium MX-13, which is honestly not as good as the one that you have in the main tree, because it doesn't have the 20mm gun, which allows you to wreck enemy guns, light vehicles, planes, but most importantly also to destroy obstacles for your hit shell. So here I have a very good bomber, but unfortunately my bombing is pretty bad, and I essentially miss everything. And as you could see before I went to my bomber, the situation was okay, and suddenly all the tanks in our team disappeared from the map. And as you can expect, the enemy team will capture B, and probably made the mistake not to take the opportunity that our team was nowhere to be seen to actually go Cap A, but that's their problem. And here I'm facing a Tiger 2P, which is a bit lost in this 8.7 battle, but as you will see, I will struggle. And obviously at this point of the game, I was a bit worried about the issue of the battle. Really surprised that this Tiger doesn't want to die. I think the last crew is the loader, and indeed I killed the loader. So let me accelerate here. I will move before my tracks are repaired. Here I have no idea why the enemy is not capping B sooner, but here it is. This M60 is capping, but I'm putting in fire. My squad mate will ultimately kill it, and I'm recapping B almost without opposition. We'll accelerate. So usually I never cross between B and C, but here we need to be sure that we will win this game. My plan was to decap C. I will use the halves in front of me to avoid to be shot by the missile of this IT-1. So as I mentioned in my main tutorial, the reason why you should not fight on C is that essentially, once you are on C, you stay on C, you stay around C, and it's almost impossible to go toward the west of the map. But in the late game, my advice is that you indeed consider capping C if there is some urgency. But obviously, that would be in very tense battles, especially when the victory really depends on capping the next tracker. So here, I'm killing this lost T-34. Again, a bit surprised to see so many people using low BR tanks again in a 8.7 battle, but that's their problem. So ultimately, as you can see, that was a pretty nice carry from my perspective. Maybe the game looked easy, but as you can see in the final scoreboard, especially with Aceworth, we essentially carried the game. I think that the two of us have actually as many or even more kills than the enemy, but again, not only kills but also caps. And as you can see in this game, I actually capped A and B twice, and they capped C. I didn't cap C at the end because just to have the opportunity to have a few more kills. So I hope that you enjoyed this Maginot Line battle game from the difficult side, but which probably suggested you some battle trick that you can use on this map. See you on the battlefield. À bientôt sur le champ de bataille.